Pacific Ocean, 90 kilometers southwest of Panama Canal, Hugo Lacerda managed to get away from the lighthouse aboard the Maria Narcissa before we could get to him. Board the ship, locate him, and make sure that he is never able to communicate what he may have learned from Morgenholt. So to run you guys up on the story, I don't know whether that was proper English or not, but I don't care at this point. Greetings, fellow oldlings. Welcome to Tom Clancy's Splinter Cell Chaos Theory. We are continuing on with the main campaign. There is only one campaign, to be honest. And what happened thus far was that a prominent scientist who was researching the Masse Kernels from Splinter Cell got kidnapped and tortured for information. Somebody was contracted to do it, and that person was Hugo Lacerda, which made him a priority target, or rather an opportunity target for the NSA. Right now, we deleted all the data that they sort of tortured out of him. Poor bastard died in the process. However, the leader, Hugo Lacerda, managed to escape onto a ship, and we basically followed him onto the ship, and our target is to eliminate him so that he cannot further relay any of the data that he has obtained from the torture. With that being said, let's go ahead and get this.
The body of kidnapped American computer engineer Bruce Morgenholt was discovered in a village in Peru this morning. Implicated in the kidnapping and failed ransom attempt is Hugo Lacerda, alleged leader of the People's Voice, a newly formed guerrilla organization. Here we see the USS Clarence E. Walsh en route to the Yellow Sea for her first assignment amid rising tensions in the region. Dubbed the flagship of a 21st century fleet by Defense Secretary Mason, who reaffirmed America's commitment to our Japanese allies.
It is our hope that the presence of the Walsh, now the world's premier electronic and information warfare platform, will help diffuse the tensions in the region.
Information you recovered in Peru makes it look like Hugo Lacerda was contracted by a third party to kidnap and interrogate Morgenholt. His payment was in weapons. He appears to be using those arms to equip his own men and pay off debts to other guerrilla groups. Maybe Lacerda is a nickel-ante loser, but maybe he's learned some things from Morgenholt that we don't want anyone to know. Maria Narcissa is out to sea, so there's no escape. Board her. Search her. Find out who Lacerda's been dealing with. And then, make sure he doesn't have an opportunity to spread what he knows. Fifth Freedom.
What Morgenholt knew about the Masse Kernels, recursive computation, and weaponized algorithms is akin to what Oppenheimer knew about atoms or what Turing knew about digital computers. Project Watson, the United Nations investigation into the Masse Kernels, will be remembered for centuries alongside the Manhattan Project as fundamental research that changed the nature of warfare forever. Imagine if Che Guevara had kidnapped and interrogated Oppenheimer in 1959, and you have a pretty accurate parallel of the situation we're in right now.
We're going to send the helicopter out about 40 clicks ahead of the Maria Narcissa and leave you in the water on her course. You'll board covertly onto the bow. Search the ship and the holds. Find out what you can about the arms shipments and who Lacerda is dealing with. Satellite imaging shows the Maria Narcissa racks a small launch on the stern. That will be your primary extraction. If things go badly, we might be able to arrange to pluck you out of the sea.
We'll keep the Walsh inside a helicopter range of the target vessel at all times. If something goes wrong, we should be able to assist in extraction. If you play it safe, we'll recover you when the ship's launched from open water once you're out of visual range of the ship.
Fisher. We just pulled up Celestinia's last dry dock report for the Maria Narcissa. They have a newly installed central alarm system.
Don't tell me. Three alarms and the mission is over?
Of course not. This is no video game, Fisher. But you don't want the whole place alerted to your presence. Keep it under control.
Alright, so this, for the sake of full disclosure, is a post-gameplay recording, and well, I was sort of being a dumbass and did not set the correct source for the recording. And this is what I got at the end. Now, basically what we need to do is wait for this guy to get all the way there, and then we are free to go. Not down the stairs, but rather down the... that place right in front of us, down the ledge. And we need to essentially make sure that those two guys over there are talking, otherwise one of the guys that's on that side is going to see us. We've got two options here. We can either keep going straight or we can take the path on the left. I actually had not seen this path. This time around, I always used this path previously, but this time around, for some reason, I never saw this path. And it's a very nice path. It takes you exactly where you want to go. Nothing on our left, just a hole on the right that we need to drop down. And it will land us safely in the shadows. From where, we just essentially jump over the railing. Or if you guys want to time it better, you can like walk down the steps as well. It doesn't really matter. However, it might not hurt to be a little cautious, as you can hurt your knees like I did. And yeah, that was sort of dumb of me, but anyway, this guy, however, I have heard that in the console versions especially, that this guy, you cannot get past him without waking him up, and you need to knock him out. And
Fisher, it looks like Lacerda is spreading around his newfound wealth, paying off debts with some of the arms that were delivered to him.
You want me to scan any more weapons crates?
Better idea. Plant tracking devices on them, and we can see who they end up getting delivered to.
Okay.
That's a nice strategy to figure out who the targets are. Upcoming targets. Anyhow, I'm just looking for crates right now. I won't find any right here. Because the crate is actually the next room over. It's a tiny little crate. You guys will be able to make, like, notice it pretty easily. But back to what I was saying. The guy that's sleeping there, apparently in the console versions especially, you cannot exactly get past him like that. As soon as he hears something that's beyond the threshold of sound, as is indicated by the little highlighted square at the bottom right corner of the screen, as long as the sound exceeds that, the person will know, will get alerted to your presence, basically. That's how it works in this game, but apparently in harder difficulties and in the console version, if you just try to open that door, that guy will wake up. And I don't know whether it was the devs just sort of forgot to program that in for the PC version, or whether that's a bug, or whether that is actually a bug in the console versions, but yeah, that is how it works. I'm still looking for the crate, by the way, which I have not found yet, because it's not here, it's in the next room over. And yeah, yeah, that's the first crate. It always sort of makes me nervous.
Good job, Sam. That's the first crate. Keep your eyes peeled for any more.
Alright.
It always sort of makes me nervous going through narrow spaces and on a ship. Sort of makes me feel like any of it could collapse at any moment and crush me. The same reason why I don't like going into caves, but that's just me. I guess I'm just claustrophobic that way.
Fisher, we just intercepted a radio call from the Maria Narcissa. She's reporting a hull leak and asking for an escort.
The ship is sinking.
No, but apparently several compartments are flooded. You'll need to activate the bilge in the forward machine room to access all the cargo holds.
Well, I suppose the ship is sinking just very slowly. And, yeah. I'm just trying to see if the path ahead is clear. Now, one thing about Chaos Theory is that it is quite meticulously designed, and they will not exactly keep any enemies in areas like this where it's impossible for you to see around the corner. I mean, it's not practically, I sort of closed the door on myself there, it's not practically impossible to see the enemies around the corners, it's just you need to use your sticky cam for reconnaissance, which I do believe they could have.
Fisher, those compartments are flooded. You need to activate the emergency bilge pump to drain them.
Yeah, so I guess they could have introduced a level of, how do I put it, some kind of measure to ensure that it was forced, this tendency to actually use the recon cameras instead of just going in blind into places. And I'm trying to figure out where the light is. I thought that was the light, but apparently it was not. I don't know why I thought that, but yeah, the light is actually hanging up on the ceiling there. The reflections of this game are pretty nice, so...
Yo diría que he visto algo por ahí.
And while that's going on, we just basically need to slide over the table and... crawl into the crawl space there. Pretty simple section. The next section is a place where you can sometimes run into trouble.
There should be a large pump in here that you can use to drain the forward cargo hold.
I'll find it.
Yeah, a little bit difficult to miss, Fisher, especially since there's somebody already working on it. So this is the thing that I don't understand. There are so many technicians that are always trying to fix stuff around the place, but Sam somehow manages to fix it instantly. Like, you'll notice a guy down there who's actually trying to fix the equipment right now, the pump, but he's unable to. But when Sam presses the button, it works. Do you have, like, some sort of magic touch, Sam? Is a question that I should be asking. Now, the thing about this game is, if you play it at speeds greater than... frame rates greater than 30 frames per second, lights like this, physics objects, sometimes have the tendency to just get all wonky and spin around all over the place. And I honestly have encountered that in my previous playthroughs. I don't know why I did not do that. I could not encounter that in this playthrough, maybe because it was not running at 60 FPS, my game. Maybe closer to 30 or something. So at any rate, we head down here. And I got caught the first time I tried the section. Typically I like to do it while I'm at the top, but this time around, while I was playing this mission for YouTube, I sort of decided to do it while I'm down the stairs, and if this if the difficulty was any higher than normal, then I would have been caught. Right now I'm just waiting for that guy to get off the pump so that I can use it, but that guy decides to just stay there, forcing me to use the damn OCP again. I'm a little sad to say that I don't exactly know what OCP stands for, even now. So I'm trying to distract that guy and using like a sticky cam, but for whatever reason, it distracts nobody. And I just shoot it on the wall there. I also waited for the guy at the top to move away. Well, nobody's alert. Nobody has been alerted, which is something very strange to me, so I just decided to go ahead and use the OCP again. This time, to success.
Good job. That'll drain the flooded compartments. Now you can search for the bill of lading attached to Lacerda's shipments.
Alright.
So yeah, these sections of the game have always been very tense for me. Because, well, it's pretty easy to get stuck. Like, get spotted in these sections. And I just want to make sure that I'm not spotted that easily. That being said, we basically need to head into this part right here.
I'm betting that Lacerda's shipping container is somewhere in this compartment. The bill of lading should be mounted on the side.
I'll have a look around.
Like, this level had some of the tightest tolerances for timing. At this level in particular. Like, especially that last section over there and the upcoming section with the... well, the guards and the gas room, but you'll get to notice what I'm you'll get to see what I'm talking about soon.
Good work, Sam. It looks like whoever delivered these arms to Lacerda was operating through a proxy.
Who?
Mercantil Costa Fuerda Seguridad de Panama.
Offshore bankers?
Yeah, the cigar-chomping kind.
Great. I love bureaucrats.
You still need to recover the transit ledger so we can figure out who else Lacerda is dealing with. Try the ship's office. They should have that information.
So yeah, we basically, that gave us a new objective, retrieving a transit shipment. I wonder how we do that. Oh yeah, I remember now. I was just thinking back on my previous playthroughs and trying to figure out how we did that, because I never recall going to the ship's offices. Then I remembered, oh wait, I'm thinking about the wrong place. Anyhow, yeah, I'm trying to look for another one of those boxes in here, because I don't recall the location of all these side objectives. But yeah, another thing about this level is that you cannot open doors from underneath, as is quite evident right now. I'm pretty sure Fisher being Fisher, he could have probably figured out a way to hang onto the door frame while opening the door from the inside, but apparently he cannot. Anyhow, we just need to move on from here and get back to the main area. But of course I decided to include this part for whatever reason. I do not think I remember why I decided to include this part, but since it has been included already, may you guys enjoy it as much as I am. Just watching myself aimlessly roll around. Alright, time to finally head back. I actually got caught there doing this section, because I was being a little too slow. And there are some people who are gonna come from up ahead. We need to get inside this hatch as soon as possible. Otherwise we risk getting caught. Now, I decided to wait for them right here because I saw that the path in front of me was rather well illuminated, which is actually an illusion because they can't see you, it's not that bright down there. And once they are done talking, you can essentially keep moving. Like, they'll just move away. You can take this part at your own leisure. Do it at your own pace. Take things at your own pace. Moving on. The next section is going to be one of the instances where this game is quite...
Sensors in your suit are detecting a lot of fumes down there.
Yeah, I can smell it. Some kind of gas leak.
Could be enough to be a serious explosive hazard. We can't have any firing in the engine room.
Wonderful.
And don't expect the enemy to be smart enough to realize that. They might still open fire on you if they see you.
I get the message. I'll be discreet.
And yeah, that's the thing. This game just tosses random stipulations at you, and that is, I believe, what makes this game so much fun, the infiltration in this game. You never know what's gonna happen next, and this guy just literally looks at us and then decides to look away for whatever reason. Probably because he doesn't want any piece of this, who knows, but yeah, I was about to head that way because that's how I'd always completed the section. This level was never one of my strong suits, and yeah, this time around when I was covering it for YouTube, I thought might as well play it slowly and methodically like a proper stealth game and try to figure out a proper solution to the patterns. And well, as it turns out, this section isn't actually all that difficult. I was just making it more difficult than it needed to be. And there's that guy coming back over this way. The same guy, actually. We just need to wait here until that guy starts heading back, and then we can get going on our way. Our objective is to climb up the stairs. Two flights, to be exact, and walk into a room. Now, typically what would happen is that I would take the path that this guy took while getting here, and I would sort of get spotted. Not exactly spotted, but somebody would see my outline while I'm doing my maneuver, and it would sort of more or less make God suspicious as to somebody being in their vicinity. I'm also being careful not to make too much noise while moving through the section as fast as possible, I guess one of the issues with playing with mice and mouse and keyboard is that you could set movement speeds. And despite the fact that they really tried their best to give you as many movement speeds as possible, it just isn't the same as using an analog stick. So you tend to get speeds which are, you know, which might not be optimal. For example, I could have probably gone faster, but if I tried to set my movement speed any faster, I would have been noticed by others around me because I was making too much noise. Now, this level in particular is not that difficult, but like, for instance, in this instance, I got captured because I moved too fast. Now, the levels in this section aren't all too difficult, but they aren't really all that easy either. What am I saying? The levels in this game, this level isn't too difficult, to be honest. The levels up ahead, especially towards the end, so onwards, they get really difficult, and those levels still are smooth. It's not like Chaos Theory is a particularly difficult game, but they are challenging. That is not to say that those levels are not challenging by any means. They are still very challenging levels, but yeah, those levels do tend to get smoother over time, at the same time more challenging. So this level, however, has always been sort of a weak point of mine. Right now I'm just waiting for the guard in there to come out, because there is a box inside that we need to tag, and as soon as this guy decides to come out, well, we're gonna have to go and mark that box, put a tracker on it. And this guy's gonna come outside and he's just gonna pose around at the corner for a bit. One of the little details that I love in this game is how Sam just immediately tenses up and gets ready for action every time an enemy is near him. it's one of like those tiny details about this game which makes it very, very immersive. Because in the first two games, Sam would just sit around, he would not really do much. And that, I believe, is a trend even in the latter games, because it's very fast-paced. Those games are very fast-paced. I'll refrain from making any comments about Double Agent, because that is a totally different beast altogether. Now, my next strategy is to just wait around in here until I hear the guy come back in, because at this point it is too late to successfully make your way back into the shadows. If you try to do so, the guy will notice you. I retried this particular section like 4 or 5 times, that's how I know. And yeah, he doesn't come in here. That is pretty much your only line of defense right now. I guess what could have been done was we could have actually waited inside the toilet there, and then when the guy crosses it, we could have made a move then, and we could have waited by the toilet and waited for the guy to come back in here to save time. But however, I did not do that. So right now I open the door and see this guy standing right in front of me, and I was wondering, should I just take him out? But then I remembered, no, it's a ghost playthrough, might as well close the door back up. And I guess it's all a problem of having not played any Splinter Cell title in the recent past, that I'm sort of relearning how to play these games again. And yeah, I would appreciate any patience that you guys have for any patience that you guys might have for tolerating not optimal playing behavior. If you guys have that kind of tolerance, well, I thank you for it from the bottom of my heart. Moving on, I'm just waiting for this guy to go back inside before I climb back up the stairs again. Like I said, while I used to play this mission before, when I used to play this mission before, I always sort of rushed through these entire sections. I saw an opportunity and I took it, and I typically would make guards suspicious because of my, you know, fast movement and everything.
Sam, you're near the ship's office. This deck, starboard side.
I'll find the transit ledgers there.
That's where they should be keeping them.
Okay, so right up ahead, there is a crawl space in the ground, which you guys cannot see. Neither could I until I got right next to it, which sort of surprised me. So, I mean, I've played this game before as well, but it.
¿Ha pasado la cerda por aquí? Sí, estuvo hace un rato quejándose de los libros de cuentas. Bastardo. Ojalá alguien le rebane el cuello.
It always surprises me, is what I would say.
No tengo intención de hacerlo. Espero que alguien lo haga por mí. Ese alguien puede sufrir una muerte espantosa a manos de la cerda. Oh. ¿Dónde está ahora la cerda? No lo sé ni quiero saberlo.
I guess one of the guys asked, where is la cerda? I don't know what Spanish, but from whatever meager Spanish I know, that I think that is what he asked. If there are any Spanish people who are watching this, feel free to translate. At any rate, the FVP playthrough would be in, well, English. So I decided not to go with the language translations for this playthrough, primarily because
the transit ledgers are forged. They say Lacerda's container is full of sugarcane and coconuts from a man named Nikaryakov in Malaysia.
Nikaryakov. I remember that name.
Nikaryakov is a code name that Philippine drug dealers use to indicate arms shipments.
So instead of nuts from Malaysia, Lacerda got guns from an imaginary Russian?
Exactly. Now why don't you go find out where Lacerda is hiding?
The captain probably knows where he is.
Good idea. Why don't you head to the bridge and ask?
Yeah. Malaysian nuts, that's what Lacerda is really interested in. And at this point I sort of forgot that there's this guy who basically patrols the area. And I sort of panicked and just stuck to the door as best I could. Thankfully this is Chaos Theory and not Pandora Tomorrow or the original Splinter Cell, otherwise this guy would have noticed me here. Now, the thing about this game is the English translations. I mean, if you use the native languages setting enabled, play the game with the native languages setting enabled, it plays much more smoothly. Not smoothly, I would say. The game remains far more immersive. Because typically, if you don't use that setting, if the way these guys speak their English is pretty, well, they've got very forced accents. It sounds very fake. It does not sound true to life. Pedro to Cornelio. I'm very worried about the sealant rings on the gas pipes. We already have several small gas leaks. If it gets worse, a single spark could sink this rat trap. Now, reading this message, it sort of makes me wonder whether there was a pathway we could have come here from the top of the ship instead of the bottom, the way we came here. Because that message being there sort of suggests that there's nothing in here, by the way, in this room, I mean. Except for a medkit if you really need it. So that message link, they sort of suggest that it could have been placed there as a, how do I put this, I'm gonna open and check anyway, as a piece of information for when we are heading downstairs. Maybe the initially planned level design for the ship was to infiltrate from the top to the bottom, but yeah, I guess, I don't know why they have that piece of email there, maybe just to add some more flavor to the game, who knows. Anyhow, so yeah, the English translations have got very heavy regional accents, and I've got nothing against regional accents, but the way that they've been handled this game, they feel very artificial, like the accents seem very forced instead of being natural. And there's another crate, by the way.
Okay, Sam. Judging by the numbering on the crates, that's about half of them. See if you can find the rest.
There are only two more crates, to be honest. No more. Oh wait, there are three more crates, actually. Yeah, there are six in total. So that was a neat little trick which I hope to try out later on in this game, in the level bathhouse. You can actually jump up to grab ledges just like you could in the first Splinter Cell game, but the way that this game is designed is so damn smooth that you don't really see yourself pulling off acrobatic stunts like this. It feels like hacking the game almost whenever you do something like this instead of, you know, taking the stairs, because everything in this game has been so meticulously crafted. So yeah, that's the reason why I prefer using the native languages setting in the sound settings, because it just adds immersion to the game. It makes me feel like Sam is actually the person who can speak like a buttload of languages, or has like a babelfish in his ear, and doesn't really need to, you know, rely on just English. Now, there's a captain in the door behind us. We could have interrogated him to figure out where Lacerda is, but since this is a ghost playthrough, I do not want to interrogate a civilian. Actually, that guy's not really a civilian, he's still Lacerda's man. Anyhow, this is the other place where you can find out information about where Lacerda is. Now, I think I sort of forced doing what I'm about to do next. So what I did right here was I knocked this guy out and accessed the computer. After playing this level is when I realized, you know what, I could probably just... Yeah, I tried accessing it through my binocs, but I could not. Because this is an embedded system, that is an exception to the kind of systems that you can access through your binocs. And so, what I probably could have done was used a sticky cam to distract this guy and then access the data from the computer. But I decided to just go ahead and knock him out instead. Drag him all the way to the shadows. So, at this point it was a choice between either knocking this guy out or the captain, so I decided to knock this guy out. Although I think I probably could have just distracted him, which is something that I figured out while editing through this video. Anyhow.
So Lacerda is holed up in the captain's quarters.
Where's that?
Third deck, port side. The two interior stairwells are the only access to that deck.
The body of American Bruce Morgenholt was recovered in Peru today. No cause of death has been announced, but the US State Department has demanded an apology from the Peruvian army for their possible role in a botched rescue operation. They were nowhere near the place, and the guy was electrocuted to death right in front of our very eyes. Or near our ears, at least. I mean, we saw his nipples being teased through the shadows. So anyway, now we know how to get to Lacerda. The question is, how do we get there? Under the nifty little trick, you can actually use your thermal vision to peek through thin surfaces, like thin sheets of metal and panels of wood or paper. Now, I could have gone right, but that would have exposed me to the light, and I wanted to avoid that, being the reason why I decided to go left here. Now, I do not know how I will ever manage to complete this section if I'm playing it in realistic difficulty, because how that works is the light meter at the bottom right, it has to stick to the very corner. The moment it leaves that corner, the enemies can see you. And if it ever clears that section, the very first section, you are essentially spotted. So it's pretty hardcore, to be honest. And the captain is right in front of us, but thankfully he did not see us, which is good news. I hope this radio recording does not get me a copyright strike, to be honest. So yeah, we used a shortcut there, jumped off the side instead of sitting to the front. But yeah, I like the recording, the sounds, not the sounds, the songs in this game, they all seem very, very nice. I mean, to be honest, I'm quite into metal and rock as well, so perhaps that's the reason why. Oh yeah, come back here, because I just remember that there was probably something of importance in here. I don't exactly remember what, but I remember there being something interesting in here, which apparently was a mistake, because it's just a bathroom. And no, I was playing the Big This Mission sometime before I started my YouTube channel, during one of my countless replays of this game, and for some reason I just thought that that might have something in that room there. But yeah, because I recall going in there and being like, whoa, that's another ammo crate, by the way.
Good job, Sam. Two more crates to go.
Weapons crate. I don't know why I keep calling it ammo crate. And yeah, the door to our left is where Lacerda is. Now there's another weapons crate downstairs. But we decide to chase Lacerda for the time being. Hugo Lacerda.
I tell you, never. Never in my life have I been so insulted.
I don't see why you're so upset. He got you past the inspection. You think it's easy to get through the canal zone with all the crackdowns these days?
I don't care if it's hard. You think my job is easy? No. But this insult, forcing me to bribe an inspector out of my own pocket. No. This big shot, this Vice President Señor Segundo Ruiz de Medeiros. Ha! I'll show him.
Fine.
Mark my words. I'll make him pay. I'll make him pay double, or my name is not Hugo Lacerda.
Great.
I need another drink.
So yeah, you guys sort of got a glimpse of...
Let me see.
The... subtitles there. So you just stick around here and this guy is gonna come out and try looking for another drink anyway. And that's when we nab him, and we take him into the shadows. All the way into the toilet. And then we interrogate him. So...
Shh! Don't make a scene.
Madre de Dios!
Not exactly. But if it makes you feel better to pray...
Please don't kill me! Please let me go. I won't tell them I saw you.
You don't understand what's happening here, do you? Morgenholt, your goons tortured him to death and I'm holding you responsible.
Oh, no! It's not my fault!
The only thing worse than a coward is a liar. You gave the order and now you're gonna die for it.
Please!
First, tell me who contracted you to kidnap him.
I don't know. I swear! I was contacted indirectly. I was warned not to try and find out. I'm sorry. It's not my fault.
Yeah, and we essentially just kill him right here. I'm trying to figure out how to...
I'm sorry! It's not my fault!
...tune this guy. But...
Good job, Fisher. I'll inform the Joint Chiefs that Lacerda is no longer a threat. Primary objectives are completed. We can extract you whenever you're ready.
So despite that, there is still something that I need to do. All that wine will go to waste with the door of the fridge being open like that. I wonder why his buddies still haven't come checking in on him yet. At any rate, we still need to go downstairs. And yeah, as soon as we go downstairs, we will find one of the additional crates for which we need to take a slight detour in this game. No other way around it, really. Unless there is, and I'm just not aware of it.
Hay algo que no entiendo. Se supone que llevamos café de Colombia.
I think there was another way to get inside this entire section through the door on the left there, the path on the left there. El capitán Diego compra el café más barato que And we just wait for these guys to just start moving. And once they do, we take out the first light, essentially. The light closer to the door so that we can actually get inside without being spotted. Now, what I'm basically waiting for is for the guy that's near the door to actually get inside and move into the freezer. Yeah, now we clear to essentially target the light. If this was...
Way to go, Fisher. One more crate to go.
If I was playing with a realistic setting right now, I would have been seen. But since this is not on the realistic difficulty, this was significantly easier for me, this section, I mean. Realistic, I'm pretty sure, is another kind of beast altogether. And that's it, there's nothing really down there downstairs. It's just a door that you cannot really open. And I don't know why, but I sort of got curious about it once I got all the way up here and decided that I just had to get back down and check it out. Yeah, I came all the way here just to go back this way. Sort of a bad move, if you ask me. Like, a pretty useless thing. Waste of movement. And I do the same thing all over again, probably because I sort of find a level of safety in the shadows. Oh well, whatever happens, happens, I guess. So, yeah, there's nothing else down there, honestly, just a bit of shadow and a door that cannot be opened. Absolutely nothing else. I guess they just wanted you to explore the area for some reason. Some very odd reason. So yeah, there were two stables to this level, and I wonder where the other stable is. Maybe I could figure it out by... exploring the game more when I play it in the...
Timonel?
Sí, capitán.
FVP mode.
Rumbo 88 grados 6 minutos. Mantén la velocidad.
Sí, señor.
¿Todo despejado?
Sí, señor.
Gracias.
So, yeah, that's the captain that we typically need to grab and interrogate. This time, however, he did not see us, and we cannot be more thankful for that. He's just gonna stand there for now. Like, once we trigger that conversation, he just keeps standing there. Doesn't do anything else, really. And that's it. We just need to get like one last crate, which is on the way to extraction, actually. And we are officially done with this level. So once we drop down this ladder, we're going to, you can see the crate right here, in this, towards the right of the screen. It was towards the right of the screen, near the center of the, well, the bow of the ship, if I'm not wrong. And yeah, if we go to the right, that's basically, if we climb up the stairs over there, that's the boat waiting for extraction, a lifeboat. But down here is where the last weapons crate is that we need to put a tracker on. Don't know why they decided to keep it all over these inside. And why they can't plant a tracker on it from the side.
That was the last of the weapons crates, Sam. Now we'll be able to track them wherever they go and see just how connected Lacerda is.
And that's it. That was all there was for this level. Pretty sure I didn't play it optimally, but I never really could play this mission optimally. Anyhow, we just move towards that potion there, and we can call for extraction. I don't know what this is though. It seems like some sort of door instead of a ship or a boat of sorts. But yeah, that was that for this mission. And that was that for Mission Cargo Ship. One of the things that I would like to point out here is the fact that we have a new tab called Bonus Objectives. You don't always get this tab. You have to trigger this tab into coming over. you only get the stamp when you complete certain objectives that the game does not tell you about. Consider these hidden objectives, if you will. Typically, even if you do not complete these objectives, your mission score will not be harmed. The game will pretend like nothing ever happened. But if you do complete these, be careful. Because if sometimes these bonus objectives only show up after you've completed certain actions, and sometimes these bonus objectives can have multiple paths to them. So if in the instance, for example, in Seoul, you have a bonus objective comprising of two or three parts, then you will have to complete all parts, otherwise your score will take a hit. So yeah, be careful about that. Now, as far as this mission is concerned, we came in to figure out, well, to one, eliminate Lacerda, and two, figure out who is bankrolling him and who essentially hired him to do this operation. While we didn't really know who hired him to do this operation, it was pretty shady stuff. We figured out that he has contacts with a certain Panamanian bank. And we also figured out that he's been receiving arms shipments from a Russian called Stanley Nikaryukov from Malaysia, who's been sending him coconuts and sugar canes. So, hand grenades and Kalashnikovs, apparently. Anyhow. that was that for Mission Cargo Ship. The lead points us towards a certain bank in Panama. And that's where we headed in the next mission, which is essentially widely considered to be the best mission in all of Chaos Theory, if not the entire Splinter Cell franchise, to be honest, because of the way that you can play it by any means that you choose to. It's very, very open-ended, and emergent is the word that, well, game theorists or game developers like to use. Anyhow, this was it for Mission Cargo Ship. Thank you so much for tuning in. Thank you so much for watching, and thank you so much for sticking around until the end. The next time we come back, we will be covering Mission Bank. Until then, take care. Fare thee well, fellow Earthlings.